You ever see those commercials suggesting people take a tiny dose of aspirin every single day? It's an amount so small it doesn't really work, at least for pain relief. Yet taking low-dose aspirin is fairly common among those at risk for heart attacks or stroke. Here's why aspirin works in a baby-sized dose. Remember, the only thing worse than a fake TV doctor is a fake YouTube doctor. We're here to tell you how aspirin works, not what you should do with it. Talk about that stuff with your doctor, not us. This small 81 milligram dose of aspirin is sometimes called baby aspirin because it was originally meant for kids. But aspirin is rarely given to children anymore due to their elevated risk of a serious brain and liver condition called RISE syndrome. Instead, low-dose aspirin has found a new niche, being taken daily by folks at risk of a heart attack or other conditions related to blood clots, like stroke. Aspirin, or acetylsalicylic acid, is a molecule with an impressive pedigree. Its close chemical cousin salicylic acid, derived from natural sources like willow bark, has been in use as a pain reliever for literally thousands of years. Since 1897, we've used aspirin instead, which does the same things, it's just easier on the stomach. The things it does aren't limited to relieving pain. They also include reducing inflammation and preventing blood clots. Blood clotting is a good thing when you've got a big gash in your arm and your blood is rapidly going from being inside your body to being outside it. Small bodies called platelets clump together and block off the flow of blood, halting its rapid escape. But when those clumps form inside your veins and arteries, it can be pretty bad news. When a blood clot interferes with the flow of blood to the heart, it's a heart attack. If it's blocking off a part of your brain, that's a stroke. And other parts of the body can be affected as well by what's more generally referred to as a thrombosis. You really don't want blood clots anywhere inside you. Which is why many people, especially if they've already had a heart attack or stroke, or been diagnosed with coronary artery disease, may be advised by their doctor to take a low dose of aspirin every day to prevent blood clots from causing another serious incident. Here's how it works. When a platelet cell detects an injury, it kicks off a series of chemical reactions that result in the production of thromboxane A2, a chemical signal that helps recruit other platelets to form a clump, which is to say, a blood clot. This process starts with a type of fatty acid called arachidonic acid. The enzyme COX-1 catalyzes the reaction of this molecule into prostaglandin H2, or PGH2 for short. PGH2 is crucial for blood clotting because it's the precursor molecule needed to create the clotting signal thromboxane A2. This is where aspirin comes in. The COX-1 enzyme has a cleft in its structure that's a perfect fit for arachidonic acid. The aspirin binds to the enzyme and blocks the arachidonic acid from entering this pocket, which puts the brakes on the production of PGH2. No PGH2 means no signals can be made from it, and that makes it much harder for blood to clot. Which also explains why one of the side effects of aspirin is a risk of bleeding, which can be serious. So again, don't just grab aspirin off the shelf because we told you it's neat. Ask your doctor. Aspirin's effects in preventing clotting signal production are relatively permanent. Once aspirin has bound to COX-1, it doesn't come back off. The body has to make whole new platelets with fresh COX-1, and that takes a few days. Taking even a small amount of aspirin daily keeps the new COX-1 molecules in those fresh cells locked down too. That's why 81 milligrams per day is plenty for folks who are trying to avoid another heart attack. Even a small amount of aspirin works great. But because it's absorbed by the body and goes to work pretty quickly, a full pain relief strength dose of 325 milligrams might be given as an intervention when someone is actually having a heart attack. So now you know why a bottle of baby aspirin is actually for grown-ups and could save their life. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and want to learn more chemistry with us, be sure to like and subscribe before you go, and turn on notifications so we can be in your inbox as regularly as a dose of acetylsalicylic acid. We'll see you next week.